Hi, and welcome to my review of the 17-inch Apple iMac G4. Even though this computer is nearly 10 years old, many people have said that it actually looks far beyond its time, perhaps something out of 2001 A Space Odyssey. The space-age design, however, was actually born out of compromise. Originally, Steve Jobs and the design team had wanted to create something that would look like the iMac G5 that we see today. However, at the time, technological constraints meant that the drives couldn't be placed sideways behind the display, as they'd have to be slowed down very much, especially the optical drive. You couldn't have had a super drive in that place. As Steve Jobs said during the keynote,
"Why don't we let each element be true to itself?"
They decided that they would put the logic board and all the drives underneath one central dome at the base of the computer. That would allow the display to hover above it, and would allow it to be completely flat. In order to bridge the gap between these two key elements, the team decided to place a stainless steel bar. This is many people's favourite feature about the iMac G4, as it allows the display to be placed almost anywhere the user wants it. Notice how when you move the display down, it still stays parallel. The arm also allows complete 180-degree flexibility of the screen, allowing you to show it to anyone. Due to the radical design of the G4, many have compared it to an angle poised lamp, like you can see on the right here. Although Steve Jobs referred to it more as a sunflower, with the head resting on top of a stalk. Internally, the iMac G4 was never a very customizable machine. Underneath an access plate at the base of the computer, you could upgrade the RAM and also add an airport card. But this was just about all that Apple wanted you to do. You can, however, upgrade the RAM in the later models of 1 GHz and above to a maximum of 2 GB unofficially, although to do this is quite difficult as you have to sever two metal points and replace it with thermal paste. Moving on to the display. As you can see, it's clearly flat panel, taking up less than an inch in width. In fact, it was with the G4 iMac that Steve Jobs officially announced the death of the CRT, although this would be available on the later eMac models.
"And I think this is the official death of the CRT today."
For me, the quality of this display is what still makes the iMac G4 incredibly nice to use. The iMac G4 shipped with three different display options, 15, 17, and 20-inch. The model you see here is the 17-inch, with a 1440x900 resolution, excellent for the time. Despite the great quality display, you can't expect the iMac G4 to be a graphical workhorse. This is because the graphics chip was again soldered onto the board, and so couldn't be upgraded. This means that you won't be able to run high definition video on it without it being extremely choppy. However, it can easily manage DVD quality video and still looks stunning. Another key feature of the design of the iMac G4 is its slot loading tray drive. Depending on which model you bought, this could either be a CD-RW, CD read-write, or DVD read. In terms of operating system, the iMac G4 can run up to Leopard, although you'll need a 1 or 1.25 GHz chip to do this. For the other versions, the best operating system to go with is Tiger. It runs most smoothly, and still allows you to open most applications that you need to use today. I wouldn't recommend the iMac G4 to be used as a main computer today. However, it does make a great guest computer, and looks great just about anywhere. It might not be the most functional computer, or for that matter the most powerful that I've ever used, but there's a certain charm about the iMac G4 that I think you really need to use to be captured by it. Thanks very much for watching. Don't forget to check out the other videos on my channel, and I'll leave you with this little clip. It's an advert from when the iMac G4 was released that I think really sums up the product.
Wait till you meet the new iMac.